Many breath studies look at specific markers in breaths for a certain disease, but it's very difficult to see what does the average person's breath look like. So our plan is to be able to look at a baseline of just a general population. Once we've established our baseline, we want to be able to apply this to jobs that have cognitive decline, such as an ER doctor. So for example, after an 18-hour shift, cognitive decline could lead to costly mistakes that we would like to try to prevent.
So different individuals may have seen different devices that are used as breathalyzers, such as those by police officers that are used to measure blood alcohol concentration. And one of the benefits of devices like that is that you get your answers in real time. And so what we do is we have an individual step up to our instrument and breathe into it. And then those molecules are then ionized and separated by their size and shape. And then they're sent into the mass spectrometer, where we then separate them again by their masses, and then we can actually then break them apart into tiny pieces and then take those tiny pieces and put them back together to learn more about the original structure of the molecule.
What we're really looking for in the baseline is a change in features. Rather than one particular molecule, we're looking at how a person's breath print in general is changing.
Well, first of all, what is a breath print? Well, if we think about it and compare it to a fingerprint, you have all the different points of comparison in a fingerprint: lines, ridges, dots. And so that's kind of what we're trying to do with breath. And so we're trying to take our data files and put all those different chemical information in there and combine that as a whole to create a breath print.
What we want to be able to do is take that individual blueprint or fingerprint and stitch different people's breath prints together so that we can create a very good average baseline for people in general.
And so once we have that baseline and seeing how that compares to different people, then we can look at different states, such as fatigue, for example. And so we can then compare like my breath print in normal conditions to my breath print when I'm extremely fatigued then, and see how those two different breath prints compare to each other. And if they are significantly different, then we can then take that and say, okay, we need this person to take a break, relax before going back to work, because we don't want costly mistakes to occur. Once we have completed our initial study here, then we're going to take our setup down to the University of New Mexico at Albuquerque and go ahead and place this setup in the emergency room at the hospital there, and then sample breath from different people. So expand our baseline there, but also then test hospital personnel and see if we can then look for different chemical signatures of fatigue and compare that to our baseline that we've established.